everybody. This is your girl, Myesha Lake. I was thinking about you today, and I just had to... Okay, hold on. Yes, yes, yes. I do have a scarf on my head. Don't judge me, okay? It's one of those days. But listen, I'm so excited because I have some awesome information to share with you, okay? And the information that's been laid on my heart to share with you has a lot to do with me. And what I mean by that is the last couple of days, I have been trying to get my body to line up with what I know, my spirit and my body to line up with what I know. What do I mean by that? What I mean is I know that I am a woman of prayer. I know that I'm a woman of excellence. I know that I'm a woman of greatness. I know that I'm a woman of divine purpose and destiny. I know that I'm a woman of prosperity, a woman of prayer, a woman of faith, a woman that has greatness inside of her and that has a lot to share with the world. I know that I'm a woman who is chosen by God. I know that I am the head and not the tail. I know that I am blessed and that I have been fearfully and wonderfully made. I know that I am the lender and not the borrower. I know a whole bunch of different things, okay? But my body was not lining up with all of the things that I know. So that led me to you. Because on this journey that we are taking, okay, to reach our divine purpose and our divine destiny, there are going to be moments, there are going to be days, there may even be weeks that you do not feel like what you know. Okay, there's going to be moments when you don't feel worthy. You don't feel that you're worth anything. You don't feel that what God has given you to do is making a difference or an impact on other people. Sometimes you may even begin to question the word of God that has been spoken over your life. Sometimes you will begin to question what your real purpose is. You may have thought on one day that your purpose was this, but then the next day you'd be like, okay, well, is that really what it is that I'm supposed to be doing? But I want you to know and understand that no matter what your body says, no matter what your feelings say, no matter what your emotions say, you have to stand on what you know. And you have to decree and declare what you know over your life every single day. Not to say that you're still not going to have those moments of weakness, that you're not going to have those moments where you're questioning and you're not sure, and God, is this really what you're saying? But I want you to be encouraged and to understand that when you are moving forth in your assignment, when you are moving forward to your purpose and into your destiny, there is virtue that is leaving you. Because you are impacting and touching people's lives. There are things that are going on within you that the spirit of man, the spirit does not strive with man all the time. So I say all of that to say that you are going to have those moments. It is normal for you to sit back and feel like, okay, I'm not feeling it today. I'm not feeling good. I don't feel like doing anything. And whatever that anything is for you may be completely different, whoever you are. I'm not sure what it is that God has called for you to do. But what I'm saying to you is there are going to be moments when you don't feel like doing anything and when you don't feel that you're equipped or able to do it. But what God revealed to me the other day is that in those moments, instead of having a pity party, because the devil wants you to wallow, he wants you to be depressed, he wants you to be unsure about yourself, he wants you to be unsure about your calling. But in those moments, I want you to reject, cast down, and send back every assignment and attack of the enemy that tries to get you off track. Because that invitation that he's sending you, you need to check no to the Evite. You need to check no, as our wonderful motivational speaker, Lisa Nichols, always says, check no, I will not be attending. Let that devil know that he has no place in your life. But instead of feeling down, instead of feeling worthless, instead of feeling weary and taken in and actually receiving that feeling into your spirit, what you need to be doing and saying, okay, Lord, I receive this. Lord, what I do receive is the fact that you want to restore my spirit. What I do receive is the fact that you want to feed me, that you want to speak to me, that you want to give me direction for my next assignment and the next piece to your assignment. Because we all know that God gives you bits and pieces. He's not going to tell you everything right now. He's not going to tell you everything in the beginning. He's going to say, do a little bit of this, then you'll do that, then he'll give you your next assignment. So from now on, when you have those moments where you're feeling weak and weary, instead of saying, oh, I just don't feel good, and Lord, what's going on with me? Instead of saying that and asking those questions, say, Lord, your servant is here, and she is listening. Your servant is here, and he is listening. Lord, speak to me. Your servant is listening. What is it that you want to tell me? And allow him to speak to you. And sometimes he won't speak to you. Sometimes it will be silent. But in those moments, let him refresh you. Let him restore you. Let him renew your spirit so that you can move forth in your next assignment in God. So men and women of purpose and destiny, I want you to be encouraged. I want you to keep moving forward. I am extremely excited because there are things that I don't even know what God is doing in me. But I thank God for the elevation. I thank God for the increase. I thank all of you for joining me. Because this journey, my Makeover Cafe, is not just for me. It's for all of us. All that is willing and ready to receive the spirit of excellence over your life and who wants to walk and move forward into their purpose and destiny. So thank you for joining me. Thank you for receiving the nuggets that God is giving me for my life that I am sharing with you. And I pray that you be blessed and that you stay encouraged. In Jesus' name, have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.